For the latest film interviews, reviews and everything making news in pop culture, subscribe to Film Companion now.
Most of us are comics / improvisers. So none of us thought that, chalo aaj baithe dark comedy banate. Why don't we make everybody uncomfortable? After we finished the most romantic episode of the fucking season, one of the people in the room responded saying, so what's the deal with Nikhil? Has he lost his game from season 1 to season 2?
Oh, the pleasure that came in my body, I never forget.
Especially we had the very, because second season, थोड़ा ज्यादा ही कनक गया ना, तो इट बिकेम वेरी डिफिकल्ट बिकॉज़ देयर वर लिटरली स्टेजेस इन व्हिच यू हैड टू क्रिएट टेंशन एंड देन देयर वाज अ जोक
एंड
देन द टेंशन एंड देन एंड वी आर जस्ट आई एम जस्ट लुकिंग एट मम्मा मी आर टोटली गोइंग लाइक इट कैसे होगा ये यू आस्क क्वेश्चन या सचिन अदरवाइज आई विल कीप ऑन टॉकिंग
चिड़िया ड्रेस
No, Ray. It's this other top that I found that I'm trying. Oh. I'm trying to make my outside look pretty to feel good on the inside.
That's right, guys. This is how you create dark comedy.
You just cover it all up.
That's the secret. Best things about the show. It really is a conversation. I think it's impossible to watch Pushpa Bali without desperately talking to a friend about who's right, who's wrong, you know, where the line is.
Yeah.
So I want to ask both of you, what is your relationship with her, with Pushpa Bali? Because I read somewhere where you both said that neither of you sympathize with her.
No.
Yeah.
So,
fucking hate the bitch.
Yeah, not at all. For me, I know the end, right? And as a director, when you come onto a show, you know the character in its entirety. You don't know the character as it's progressing through episodes. So, for me, at least, it's not a journey I'm taking as the audience is taking it. It's my job to make sure the audience takes the journey the way I intend them to, so that they feel for the character and at some point sympathize with, like, at least when they're saying, oh God, why is she doing this? They're saying it in a way that, you know, she's a friend and you're like, yaar, kyun kar rahi hai ye? Rather than being like, oh God, this is disgusting. It's my job to make that happen. But for me, when I enter a project, I'm looking at the character in its entirety. So I know everything that she's done. And I don't sympathize with her because I don't agree with a lot of things that she's done. I understand a lot of why she's done it. But I don't sympathize with her because, I mean, and this I've told Sumukhi, if someone I knew did this, I would have slapped them. And I would have like physically chained them to a bed and said, no, you are not going to go and meet this person. No, Sumukhi, I told you this.
Absolutely.
No? Where you're looking, tell.
Start writing notes from this conversation. Don't piss Debbie off. A girl who with such so low self-esteem, with clear insecurity issues and daddy issues, will be like, you've hurt my pride. And now I'm going to show you how this is going to work. But this dumb fuck has no worldly wisdom to at least hash out a nice revenge plan. This idiot is doing the worst things. I'm like, you loser. At least get laid once to know how to do this. No. This stupid woman is just making it worse for herself. And I think she is that. She is very... bothers, you know, right? Her actions are so intense, but she's still so innocent because she's not realizing that it's not like... You know, her thoughts about the world is very black and white, but her actions are so gray. It's so confusing. I'm like, one day just sleep, no, whole day. Don't do anything.
That's also a testament to her performance and her acting of that character, because that character is like that. Imagine, no, someone who set out to take revenge. Thoda ladke ne kuch achha bol diya and you're like, hi, sweetie. Idiot. Matlab, why am I? What's up? And then suddenly there's something else and you're like, fuck you. I'm going to fuck you now. So season two, in fact, season one was a very clean escalation. Season two was, she kept going back and forth on her own plan, which again imitates reality, right? When you are planning on doing something that is very clearly wrong, or you know you're doing, there is a lot of in your head where you'll be like, fuck it, I'm not doing this, or fuck it, I'm doing, or fuck it, go for it, or of course that person deserved this, or no, faltu me, why am I escalating? Which is exactly what happened with Pushpa Bali in season two.
I want to ask about the casting as well, because sometimes you get the sense that you guys have intentionally cast people who, you know, in Naveen's case, we've seen him play a very likable, funny guy on screen. Here, he's playing a much more messed up person. Even with Basu, you know, we haven't seen Shraddha before, but she just seems like such a wonderful person. So was that intentional to take people who appear to be likable and make them sort of more messed up? And because it really adds to the impact of the show.
No, and only Naveen, like, yeah, only Naveen's was, because Naveen and I had this thing where I was angry in Better Life Foundation. So, and he wasn't. Yeah. So I'm like, chalo, let's switch it. So you be this guy and I'll be the slightly more likable person.
What we would do, I mean, as is the casting process, we'd pick like one particular scene. Like for Pearl in the first season, it was that one where she was like, whatever, sweater wearing, whatever, Scorpio driving. Fuck me in the back of my Scorpio. That was the scene that for us was like, if any girl can nail this without making us feel cringy, then that's the scene. And even T-Boy had like, one, so we had picked particular scenes that we knew that if they nailed this, we knew that they were this thing. And the minute we got, like, with, for example, with Vasu, she was always meant to be an older character, but she nailed it so well that we went with Shraddha because we were like, there's no one who can play Vasu better. You know, even with T-Boy, he was not meant to be, you know, he was meant to be a Malayali character. But because this guy had this thing about him, so other than Naveen, there was no specific casting there were no casting choices like, oh, this one looks sweet, let's make them horrible, or, you know, or some such, like, take a person who fits a certain mold and flip it. But there was a lot of adjusting in terms of what we wanted to, basically, take the performance was given priority over choices that, over calls that were taken on paper. Like, you know, that it's okay that Vasu is not old, and it's okay that Diva is not Malayali, so long as we get the right kind of tone and the right performance out of it.
How do you pun on dialogues to make them interesting? I mean, do you have to have a comedy background to do that?
The best way that has worked for me is to improvise dialogues with my fellow writers, because it always gives you the most natural tone. But the fear in that is that then all your characters sound the same, because you only have limited writers, and then everybody will sound like a Naveen or everybody will sound like a Sumukhi. When you know it, once you know your characters, like I know my mother is like the mother of Pushpavali, mother character is clearly, I call this as the game of the scene and the game of the character. The game of the character is that she doesn't have time. She's lost her husband. She needs to get this girl married. It's not like she's a shit mother. She's just like, I don't have time. I don't have time for your bullshit. Figure it out. Let's go. So that's why her joke is also very like, it hurts you. We're like, why you are hurting me so much? So once you know the game of the character, game of the scene, then you know that, okay, this person will speak like this in this situation.
I remember Pankaj telling me, Naveen telling us that I will write the romance this time because you guys write cringe shit. I'm like, you know what? You write. And then he wrote Nikhil and Pushpavali, and Sumaira was so upset. She was so upset. She's like, it's not. I'm not feeling it. I'm not feeling it. And he's like, this is how romance is written. We're like, cool. So then we did a reading, okay, for a bunch of people. Now this you have to give credit to all of us, is that we take feedback. And if someone hates on us, we don't get aggressive. We're like, okay, cool, fine. We get it that we're shit, okay? And I remember one girl, after I finished the most romantic episode of the fucking season, one of the people in the room responded saying, so what's the deal with Nikhil? Has he lost his game from season one to season two?
Oh, the pleasure that came in my body, I'll never forget. As much as we have each other's back, at that time, Aisha, Sumaira, and I just left Naveen, abandoned him. We're like, you answer. Bastard, you answer. We wait.
Sumuki, you mentioned the writer's room. I really want to ask you guys about that, because I think one of the most distinctive things about the show is the tone, which you both just talked about, where you've put us in a zone where sometimes it is hilarious and other times it's very real and uncomfortable. And I remember Naveen, Richard, you know, said to me that he's obviously one of the co-writers in the show. He said that his sensibility is more haha funny and Sumuki veers more towards sort of the darker territory. So is that one of the key elements to striking that balance, where you have a writer's room where some people specialize in funny and others specialize in real and dark and uncomfortable? Is that how you strike that balance?
I think so, because I think first season I think it was Sumaira, Naveen and I, and I think a lot of people also observed is that first season had a lot more joke, which I'm not a big fan of. Like I get very like, but it worked. So which is a good thing. But, and also the other thing is in season one, a lot of jokes for Pushpavali was not really written in our heads. We were not really in the writer's head, we were not clear where she was. So a lot of her funniness was in fact something that Debbie brought into the picture, where she was the one who milked a lot of jokes, where in fact it was a lot of fun for me. Suddenly I forgot that I had written the show with other writers, and I was just having fun. So I know season one, a lot of her funnies came out, which is why overall the show became different kinds of funnies coming from different places.
So basically in the first season, I think it happened by chance that Sumukhi and Sumaira were sort of the people who would bring the darkness and would bring the slightly more edgy, controversial, and Naveen would be the one who'd be the you know, the
cream bun overall, like, and the cream music. Bun and
the, yeah, all of that would be Naveen. Like Naveen would bring in the joke and keep it light, and he'd always be like, "Macha, why am I so angry? This was such a thing for him."
He's such a waste guy. How much he said, "Oh, I'm so angry, I'm so angry."
And then how many women tripped on him being
first of all, yeah, man. We had tweets about panties being in a bunch. First, secondly, we never told him to be that angry. FYI to everybody.